The political temperatures are soaring in poll-bound Uttar Pradesh over the IT department's raids. UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has taken a jibe at Samajwadi Party Chief Akhilesh Yadav in his rally in Rampur. Yogi Adityanath hurled the Vasooli gang jibe at Akhilesh. Yogi also said that both Chacha and Bhatija have been looting the people of Uttar Pradesh. The UP Chief Minister further said that piles of cash were found at an SP leader's home and this was meant for the development of Uttar Pradesh. Akhilesh Yadav soon hit back at Yogi Adityanath. Akhilesh alleged political vendetta and said that the BJP isn't able to defeat Samajwadi Party and hence is resorting to these kind of raids in the run-up to the elections.
पहले ये गरीब के लिए आने वाले आवास का पैसा, बिजली का ये पैसा, शौचालय का ये पैसा कहां जाता था? मैं तो ये समझ नहीं पा रहा था। लेकिन भाइयों बहनों, एक सप्ताह पहले आपने नोटों की गड्डियों के पहाड़ जेसीबी से निकालते हुए देखा होगा, कैसे समाजवादी पार्टी से जुड़े हुए नेताओं के घरों से नोट की गड्डियां निकल रही हैं। ये नोट की गड्डियां खेत और खलियानों में नहीं पैदा हो रही है, ये जनता की कमाई पे डकैती डाल करके, विकास के कार्यों को अवरुद्ध करके जो अनैतिक तरीके से इन्होंने संपत्ति अर्जित की थी, ये वही पैसा है, वही पैसा आज निकाला जा रहा है। नौजवान के लिए पहले नौकरी निकलती थी, चाचा भतीजे का पूरा गैंग वसूली पे उतर आता था और भाइयों बहनों, उसके बाद होता क्या था, भर्ती होती थी विवादित, न्यायालय लगाता था स्टे और उसके बाद नौजवान की भविष्य के साथ खिलवाड़ हो जाता था। लेकिन आज तो 4.5 लाख नौजवानों को सरकारी नौकरी हम लोगों ने दी।
साल जाते जाते जब बीजेपी मुकाबला नहीं कर पाई तो अपने सहयोगी संगठनों को भी ले आई, लोगों के घरों पे छापे पड़े। आप वो लोग हैं जिनके घरों पे छापे नहीं पड़े, लेकिन बहुत सारे लोगों के घरों पे छापे पड़े और जो खासकर हम लोगों से करीब थे उन पर छापे पड़े।
And joining me this evening on this broadcast is Ghanshyam Tiwari of the Samajwadi Party. We also have with us Anila Singh of the BJP. Wishing both of you a very happy new year and hopefully a 2022 full of peaceful debates, starting with this one. Ghanshyam, I'd like to begin with you. Your response to Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath's comment referring to Akhilesh Yadav as being part of a Vasooli gang.
Good evening, Akshita, to you, Anila ji, and every one of your viewers. And I wish everyone a very happy new year, that with our collective efforts, our nation and our society becomes harmonious, becomes a place of fulfillment and progress. With respect to what Adityanath ji has said, just look at the contrast of the day today. At a time when we announce that the poor in Uttar Pradesh will get free electricity, we announced that the farmers would get every support from the new government that will be formed by public mandate under the leadership of Akhilesh Yadav ji. Farmers will get support for irrigation. Adityanath ji has nothing to respond to. He cannot even stand up and say that they will match what Samajwadi Party is doing, because that is not their agenda. Their agenda is not the poor. And Akhilesh Yadav ji has been a performing chief minister between 2012 and 2017, so much so that in the last 5 years, Adityanath ji and his government has only reinaugurated our schemes. So as a result, there's no work to show, no amount of jibes from Adityanath, who is right now, who has lost the confidence of his own party. His own party is not saying that Ab Ki Baar Yogi Sarkar. They are saying that in order to elect Modi ji in 2024, you must vote for BJP in 2022. This is their poll campaign. So that he's lost confidence in his own party. There's nothing to show in government. The only option he has is to attack Samajwadi Party. But the reality is, in this confusion between Piyush Jain and Pushparaj Jain, BJP is a laughing stock. Prime Minister thinks that Piyush Jain is Samajwadi Party's man. And Finance Minister said that it was right for them to go and raid Pushparaj Jain's house. The Prime Minister says that Piyush Jain is wrongly brought that money together. Media report says that it was his turnover. So right now, BJP is a laughing stock. This is what happens when you turn the IT department for your political agenda. The IT department should conduct due raids across the country to ensure that black money does not become the model of economy. But for Bharatiya Janata Party, that collects 3,000 crores almost every year by their own admission and filings from unknown sources. Black money is the spine of Bharatiya Janata Party. They run the most expensive campaigns.
Let's get a response from Anila Singh on this. Anila, you know, all of the raid politics that's been happening in the last few days, the SP's contention is that there are too many coincidences here. First, you had Piyush Jain being raided. Then a few days later, Pushparaj Jain, who's part of the SP, who's an MLC with the Samajwadi Party. You know, forget their names also being common. They both live literally just a few minutes apart in Kannauj. They both belong to the same business. There is, of course, going to be a question being asked here about whether the IT department is targeting political leaders. The Samajwadi Party is saying that's why Pushparaj Jain was raided a few days after Piyush Jain.
My Ram Ram to everyone. And I wish a very happy new year, very healthy and full of happiness in the coming year. And to start with, I think the Samajwadi Party is in some sort of delusional state. And they have become Sherlock Holmes as well. You know, they are saying that the raid had to be happen on a person, on this person, Piyush Jain, but it happened on Piyush Jain because initials of both the people are the same. Imagine an IT raid happening, and what they want to say, they want to say that any raid happens like that only. No spade work is done. कि चलो आज चलते हैं और रेड करते हैं, आज कोई काम नहीं है, चलो रेड करते हैं, अच्छा चलो प्रत्युष जैन नहीं तो पीयूष जैन क्या कर लेते हैं. लाइक इफ समबडी हैज टू बी रेडेड विद द नेम ऑफ अनिल सिंह एंड देन दे रेड अनिला सिंह, दे थॉट दैट इनिशियल ऑफ बोथ द पीपल आर द सेम, ओनली द डिफरेंस और अगेंस्ट द नेम ऑफ द बोथ द पीपल आर ऑलमोस्ट द सेम. सो दिस इज लाफेबल मिस्टर तिवारी. What Samajwadi Party is giving explanation
is it too far-fetched, Ghanshyam, to kind of claim that, you know, all of this is a conspiracy? Akhilesh Yadav had said this before Pushparaj Jain.
I think Mr. Tiwari got lots of time to start with. I think I should also get some time to respond.
Okay, because go ahead, Anila. Go back to Ghanshyam. Go ahead, Anila. Finish your point.
The way Samajwadi Party is giving explanation, so they are becoming the laughing stock. Everybody knows what Lal Topi Ka Gundagardi has been. And UP people know very well that people indulged in any sort of crime and corruption or appeasement, they are directly related to Samajwadi Party or Namazwadi Party, whatever you want to call them. So simple thing is that Akhilesh Yadav ji, so you should give a better explanation or reason why your people got raided. And let me clear one thing here very well, that elections come and go. These government agencies, they are not going to sit idle. They are not going to wait that let the elections get over. They are going to do some sort of interrogation or inquiry. They have to do their job. So Mia Malik and Yaqub Mohammed, even they are being raided. Are they Samajwadi Party's people? They are or they are not. So that too has to be cleared by Mr. Tiwari. They have to give some sort of clarity. If they are saying that all people from Samajwadi Party, they are being raided. So if Piyush Jain, I mean, this is, what sort of explanation is this? Piyush
Jain? Okay, let's get an answer. Anila, I've given you time to make your point. Let's get an answer from Ghanshyam. Ghanshyam, is it very far-fetched to say that, you know, the IT department and all these agencies have got confused with names and so went after Piyush Jain and then Pushparaj Jain?
Very childish explanation.
Let's use the word chronology, famed by or defamed by Amit Shah ji. The chronology is that Pushparaj Jain ji launches the itr, Piyush Jain gets raided. Prime Minister, without knowing any details, without establishing who Piyush Jain is there a connection with Samajwadi Party, goes on a dais as Prime Minister and says that there's a link with Samajwadi Party. And the entire media, that the section of media that supports BJP, which is a large section, goes and says that Piyush Jain is Samajwadi Party's man. Then they have to backtrack when all those visuals, which are sensational, start playing out. Then they realize, oh, this Piyush Jain has nothing to do with Samajwadi Party. Then comes the Pushparaj Jain raid on the day we were doing, Akhilesh ji was going to do a press conference. the laughing stock of IT department has been made out of BJP. Whether they agree or not, the memes are everywhere. The news reports that 197 crore or 200 crore is being shown as a turnover. People have started saying that now you can turn your loot into turnover. That is what BJP does.
But then, this Ghanshyam, is the greatest, you should welcome these raids.
Washing machine of corruption.
You should welcome these raids, right? It is exposing corruption.
A man became popular across the country saying that he will attack black money. So much so that from outside he will bring and give 15 lakh rupees to every individual. People of India made him the Prime Minister. Not one rupee came back. 1 rupee, 50 paise, 10 paise. Then he did demonetization, saying 3 to 4 lakh black money will be generated from within the country. Amit Shah Ji, who he was the director of a bank, that bank created a record in India by
So then these raids, Ghanshyam, as you're saying, expose the BJP, something that the SP should be welcoming, that IT department is conducting these raids.
There is public,
There's
public support to continuously act against corruption. But please don't double speak. You can't be the richest party collecting 3,000 crores every year from unknown sources, bring in electoral bonds, have over lakhs of, in just 1 year, 2 lakh crores of wave-offs being given to corporates, and then say that you're fighting corruption. This cannot, you cannot have a 12 crore car and say you are a simple man, fakir, and an 8,000 crore plane, you are a simple man, fakir. Something has to stop somewhere.
Anila, you know, this crackdown on black money is something that the BJP has always pitched, a fight against corruption. We're months to go for the elections in Uttar Pradesh. This kind of a massive haul will raise questions, as Ghanshyam is saying, about whether the BJP has at all been successful in fighting and ending this black money culture.
Indeed, there is absolutely no doubts about it that since Bharatiya Janata Party has come to power in center and in Uttar Pradesh, if I talk about, yes, we have done each and everything to control corruption. And Samajwadi Party was one political party, or BSP was one political party in Uttar Pradesh who encouraged corruption. They did not do a single thing without managing that commission out of it. And Akhilesh Yadav ji was so sympathetic for Piyush Jain that personally he did PC. If Piyush Jain was somehow related to Bharatiya Janata Party, what was the reason why he was doing
PC? But why has it taken so many years? Why has it taken so many years for the BJP to go after the likes of Piyush Jain?
Sorry?
Why has it taken so many years for the likes of BJP to go after Piyush Jain? Someone who's clearly so very corrupt.
There are many corrupts here. And it is the work of the agencies to find evidences against them. Akhilesh Yadav ji is rhetoric because he knows it very well. The money which he was hoarding via Piyush Jain, now that money is confiscated. So many of the things which he wanted to do in the elections, maybe good, maybe bad. Now how he can do it?
It's not the SP that's in power. It's not the SP that's in power. It's the BJP that's in power. How did Piyush Jain get away for so many years?
Being raided. No, Akshita, you must try to understand. That is why this person is raided. He is not at all related to Bharatiya Janata Party. We are here to give the justice. And the justice is that you have to pay your taxes. You have to declare your money. If you're not declaring your money, or if you're hoarding anything, any asset, in the form of gold, silver, or anything else. So definitely agencies are going to do the job. If Samajwadi Party workers, supporters, if they have not done anything wrong, if IT raid or the GST people, if they have done some sort of inquiry or interrogation, they do not have to be scared of anything. But if you have done something wrong, then definitely you will make UN cry and you will try to show that aapse acha koi nahi dusra jati kar raha hai. The problem here is Samajwadi Party, everybody knows Samajwadi Party equals to what? Corruption. That is why Akhilesh Yadav ji had to come himself in person to do a PC. This shows that definitely dal mein kuch kala hai.
Okay, Ghanshyam, your response.
Well, it is very easy to argue with BJP when you are arguing on facts. It's difficult to argue on jives because it's a race to the bottom. Let's argue on facts. For example, in this debate, Anila ji said that UP is number one on crime. Dainik Bhaskar, which was also raided 4 days back, published the story that in the BJP rule, 3.4 lakh, 3 lakh 40,000. 340,000 crimes are reported every year.
I did not say that. I have to interject. Stop.
17,500.
No, no, Ghanshyam, Ghanshyam, what are you referring to here? What are you referring to? Anila mentioning these comments was when?
Southward. Stop.
I think that Anila mentioning
Diwali ji, what I did not say, please do not project. I said that. Don't put your words in my mouth. I did not say what you were saying.
Okay, one second. Anila, one second. Ghanshyam, go ahead. But, you know, where did you pick this out from? Anila saying she didn't make any such comment.
Let me rephrase. When she was blaming Samajwadi Party and Red Topi and Gundaism, and when Uttar Pradesh government every day with ads like this, look at this ad, right, in the news, taxpayers' money, puts out ads like this saying that Uttar Pradesh has exterminated crime. And then Dainik Bhaskar, which probably did not get this ad money, publishes that between 2017 to 2021, 3.4 lakh crimes a year, 17,500 kidnappings a year, 50,000 thefts a year, 56,000 crimes against women a year, 7,300 riots a year. This is published 4 days back in Dainik Bhaskar. So it is easy to argue with Bharatiya Janata Party on facts. On the point that Anila ji made, that why did Akhilesh Yadav ji need to do a press conference? When the Prime Minister of India, all these agencies eventually report to him. When the Prime Minister of India made a jibe without facts, almost rumor mongering, on Samajwadi Party, it is our duty, almost out of respectfully, to respond to the Prime Minister. Has the Prime Minister come back and showed that what was the jibes waste? It is now clear that Piyush Jain has nothing to do with Samajwadi Party, except in the jibes of Bharatiya Janata Party.
You know what
it
I'm
is
saying,
impossible to argue with BJP because the jibes are waste.
What I'm seeing in the last few minutes, one second, Anila, what I'm seeing in the last few minutes is both the SP and the BJP both trying to say Piyush Jain belongs to you, to the other party. Anila, you know, even as I'm slightly running out of time, so I just want to get your final comment on this. One issue also that, you know, is time and again raised when this kind of raid politics happens is the fact that in the run-up to almost every single election, and I can give you several examples, the Tamil Nadu election, the Karnataka election, the West Bengal election, there's almost a trend of opposition parties being targeted of these kind of raids happening with just months to go for the elections.
Then in return, I'll give you examples of all those states where raids have happened in the month of December 2021, and no elections are bound to happen there. So what you have to say about that? See, India is a huge country, and many of the states where elections used to keep on happening, it doesn't mean that these agencies are not going to work. Agencies are going to work. And Samajwadi Party can never come and send Akhilesh Yadav ji cannot become Prime Minister of this country. So it is a huge big dream for him if you think so. So definitely all these agencies are going to be under the Prime Minister, and in today's date, it is under NDA government. And indeed, Prime Minister is Narendra Modi ji.
But so the timing of it, the timing of it is really something.
Modi ji is Prime Minister and he is heading NDA government. That is why these agencies are working against Samajwadi Party. That is most lame excuse we can hear of.
Ghanshyam.
So Akhilesh Yadav ji and his team should find better excuses and stop playing.
Okay, I have a minute to end this. Ghanshyam, your response to what Anila said, I also want to ask you again. Is the Samajwadi Party going to welcome these kind of raids because it's a crackdown against corruption? You're saying you have nothing to do with Piyush Jain. Then welcome the raids. It's exposed corruption in UP.
We are saying that India will be a stronger country, a more prosperous country, if institutionally we are able to fight against corruption and especially black money. And leaders now and in future will always find a popular public agenda. But BJP is the shallowest party, the biggest washing machine of corruption that can raise that. Because in the last 5 years alone, nearly 200 MPs and MLAs from other parties have joined Bharatiya Janata Party. There are tapes and press conferences talking about how 10 crore, 20 crore were being given to everyone to switch governments, for governments to fall. So for BJP to say that raids are not politically motivated at a time when every institution is being built, every institution is being bent, it does not cut ice. In Uttar Pradesh, raids not standing, the agenda is going to be employment, the agenda is going to be price rise, agenda is going to be harmony, contrary to what BJP wants Uttar Pradesh to have. Agenda is going to be people like Ajay Mishra Traini who do not deserve to be the Minister of State for Home in India. It's a shame. It's a shame for our democracy that Ajay Mishra Traini continues to be a Minister of State for Home in India.
Okay, I've run out of time completely. Ghanshyam and Anila, thank you very much for joining us on this broadcast and putting forth your party's perspectives. Clearly, at this point, Uttar Pradesh, you can make out from this conversation itself that the political temperatures are soaring and the stage is set for an epic face-off in 2022 between the BJP, the SP and all the other political parties in the fray in the battle for Uttar Pradesh. And trust us here at India Today to get you all the latest updates on this story and much more. That's all we have time for in this broadcast. Thank you very much for tuning in.